Hey everybody, it's Druggeth with game number 3 of this matchup between Snurtle as the red Protoss player in the upper right-hand corner and Xerox as the pink Terran player in the lower left-hand corner of Steps of War. Snurtle, you switch back to red. Stop switching colors on me. It's really annoying. Anyways, on the last matchup, Snurtle was overcome easily by Xerox's 3 barracks rush with the Marauders and Marine units that he used to go into the back door on the Blistering Sands map. Very nice early rush. He did time it so that Stim did finish just about the time he got to the base, and with some miss micro from Snurtle, he ended up pulling his sentries away too far, not able to put down force field in time to block off the ramp a second time, just long enough to get the Immortal out. What ended up happening was some of the Marines and Marauders were able to sneak through. A pylon did go down and unpowered the Robo facility, so the Immortal was stuck in place. And from that point on, it was just a pain train rolling through as Xerox moved his way in. On this matchup, Xerox is a little bit upset that there's a probe inside and kind of messed off his wall. But let's see what kind of tactics we have on this map, as it looks like we might be seeing the same buildup from both sides, with Snurtle going for the Gateway Cyber Core. Let's see if he does that. However, Xerox is inside his base. Hold on, take a quick sip. Again, Snurtle not walling off his base, going for that single gas. It's been pretty effective so far, except for that 3 barracks push, and we got 1 barracks, 2 barracks, so we do have 2 barracks for Xerox going down. If we see a 3rd barracks go down, we might see the same effective army pushing into, oh, look at that, he actually snuck on by there. There's a nice little gap right there. However, when he builds the tech lab or reactor core, we'll be able to block that off. Xerox right at the end of the base. Oh, so we do have the Cyber Core going down, so Snurtle is going with the build that he did use the 2 previous games, where he will be going Gateway, Cyber Core, and probably the second Gateway right into a robotics facility, and then from there, whatever he feels like. It's second gas just finishing for him. Let's see, Barracks is finish up for Xerox. He does have his mules coming in. He is going double gas, so it doesn't look like he's going to be going for the 3 racks build that he did on the last map. However, it was extremely effective against Snurtle. And yes, Snurtle is going down with that gateway. He does have the warp gate going, though we do not have a stalker coming out immediately, which is quite weird, because even with these 1, 2, 3, 4 Marines, they could cause some damage over here. Especially just by taking out a couple of these pylons. I am really surprised that he didn't try and force out that stalker unit. And still, with 1, 2, 3, we have the 4 gates down. And no, not a single unit coming out at all. We do have pylons coming down. Let's look at the economy really quick. 22 probes over 14 SCVs. Snurtle may have noticed, economy-wise, that Xerox hasn't been keeping up. Even with these mules in place, they haven't really been keeping up. And we do have a 2 racks factory going down, though with the placement of the supply depot, looks like these 2 barracks aren't going to be able to put any tech down unless they shift out of location. And you shift just one up there, you expose that tech facility, either the tech lab or the reactor, to incoming attack, thus making a really big hole in the middle, as opposed to using the building to block off that ramp a lot better. Do we have a robo? No, we have a 5th gateway, so we get 5 gateways coming down with, look at these SCVs, the probes, 24 probes. So I'm going to assume we're going to be having a huge push, as we do have that proxy pylon in there. Look at that. Look at that, 3 stalkers and a sentry. The sentry not really doing much. 4 Marines inside that bunker, going to be able to take care of these stalkers, no problem. Falling back just a little bit with Snurtle, and Snurtle was, and 3 more stalkers are blinked in. We do have some more heavy economy going down as we see a probe coming out, and he is dropping down Twilight Council. So looks like we're going to be going right to Blink Stalkers, or if he chooses to focus more on the more on Zealots from this point out, he will be able to get Zealots. However, I do not see that he's going to be doing that. It looks like it's going to be Stalker Sentry Army focus mainly. Getting up that Guardian Shield would be, there we go, Guardian Shield reducing a lot of damage against these units from the Marines. However, not going to help against that Siege Tank, especially once that Siege Tech does get done. However, it is... Nope, did it finish? Oh, it finished just as I was talking about it. Anyways, an Engineering Bay coming down, so it looks like we're going to be going for some air defense, as Xerox might be expecting some type of airdrops going down on him. And yep, we do have the a missile turret coming down. Not much else. And no, I was mistaken. Charge is being researched, as we do have more Zealots coming into play. I think that might be a nice little plan build by Snurtle, making Xerox think that he's going to go Stalker heavy, so he's going to get the defenses in place for those Stalkers. These barracks trapped right there, not going to be able to get Marauders out, so he is going to be doing it with the Siege Tanks, trying to set up some defense, which is really a shame, as the Marauders are very well against those Stalkers. And here we have Snurtle just kind of building up his forces. So we have, let's see, 8 Zealots. You know what, there's a unit tab right there. We've got 9 Zealots, 5 Stalkers, 2 Sentries, a nice sizable army that can do some good damage against these guys, especially once Charge finishes. And in the meantime, this pylon is getting knocked down with an expansion going down right outside the base for Xerox, as we do see that Snurtle's army is starting to move in. Do we have a probe coming right up behind him for support? No, we do not. However, Charge did just finish a second ago, and Templar Archives are coming down. So, nice, Charge is going down. Those Marines are going right to the slaughter, and these Siege Tanks are getting taken down very quickly. Almost no more Zealots left. One more Zealot left on the field, and that Zealot will stay alive to fight another day, and that expansion has been taken down. Xerox back in his base. All of his defense is gone as he is rushing to get some tanks out for this defense, and Snurtle has broken down the wall, going right through that supply depot, not causing a supply block, but he is able to get into the base. He's going to knock out a couple of these missile turrets. I would actually aim for the supply depot, try and get a supply lockdown. And no, he just took a quick shot on that, and he's coming over, trying to find the factory, trying to find the units that are causing him the most damage. And a nice Guardian Shield right there, trying to lessen the damage from those tanks. And Xerox calls good game. So Xerox will be going to the third place matchup. Snurtle will be going to face off for the number one position of this championship game. So that was the last semifinal matchup. Hope you enjoyed it. I won't be doing the third place matchup until tomorrow. So this is Draugith checking out, and see you guys tomorrow.